that Jacksonville has 7 major bridges. So I want to talk to you about those bridges. So when you're moving to Jacksonville and you see all these big things, that you kind of have an idea when you hear the name, you know where you're going. So first I want to start with the 2 busiest ones. They're going to be the Acosta and the Fuller Warren. This is AKA your morning traffic bridges. This is taking people from Jacksonville and San Marco, and it's going into Riverside and downtown. Okay, effectively you're going over a bridge, over these 2 bridges, to get from in town to downtown or to Riverside and Avondale. So typically these bridges are going to get backed up in the morning because you've got people driving from St. John's County, Southside, the beaches. They're all coming from the main areas of Jacksonville and they're all going to work downtown San Marco, Riverside area. So downtown, of course, this is a lot of buildings. You got a lot of corporations down there and a lot of hospitals, so as well as in Riverside. So that's why you have so many people going down there. A lot of attorneys, of course, work at downtown. So that is your Acosta and Fuller Warren. Next is going to be your Main Street Bridge. Now, this is the iconic, gorgeous, gorgeous blue bridge. It is a drawbridge that you see in all of the skylines when you look up Jacksonville, Florida. This bridge, it lights up at night, it's blue, it's just pretty. And on the holidays, so on New Year's and the 4th of July, they've got all the fireworks that are going off of it. They've got barges that come through the water underneath the bridge, and they just have a gorgeous light display. So Main Street Bridge is really fun. It's graded and it is a drawbridge. So if you go over there, it goes up, it lets the sailboats and large yachts go through, and then it comes down. The Main Street Bridge also gets you from 95 into the heart of downtown. This is the bridge that you're gonna use if you're coming from Jacksonville and you wanna go to the stadium. So that is the Blue Bridge. Next is going to be the Hart. The Hart Bridge, if you are living on the south side in the beaches, you're actually gonna be able to take Beach Boulevard and go over the Hart Bridge. Now the Hart Bridge is a big long bridge. It's also high and it's kind of swirly, kind of like a roller coaster bridge. It is full concrete. So you're actually gonna go from Beach Boulevard, you're gonna go over the Hart Bridge, and you're gonna get 2 options. So your first option is gonna be to go left, and that can take you to the stadium, or you can go right and that's going to take you into downtown, more of that Springfield, MLK, heart of downtown, a little more north side. Next is the Matthews Bridge. Now let me just tell you, I don't go over the Matthews Bridge. This is your purple bridge. This is the bridge that takes you from Atlantic, Regency, and again it will put you into downtown. This was an old graded bridge. I'm not a fan of it. I will avoid the Matthews Bridge at all costs, yet people go over it every single day. That's just a local's perspective. The next bridge is the Dames Point Bridge. The Dames Point is like, that's the bridge that you have nightmares about, right? This is the bridge that goes up and straight down. That is the Dames Point. It actually takes you, so you're gonna take 295, you're gonna go around past Merrill Road, and it's going to take you to the northeast side of Jacksonville. So you can actually go to Heckscher. Once you go over the Dames Point Bridge, it will take you to Heckscher, which is going to bring you down to Fernandina and Amelia Island. It's a super pretty drive. Or you can continue going to the back end and it will continue 295, which will help get you to the airport. Next is, oh my God, the bridges of all bridges, which is the Buckman Bridge. So the Buckman Bridge is a 3-mile long bridge that connects Jacksonville to Orange Park. Now, what happens is a lot of people live in Orange Park, Fleming Island, Middleburg, because it's a great value for the home and they want to work in Jacksonville. So they're getting a great value for their home, but you have to cross the Buckman. That is the downside to living in Orange Park. If you work in Jacksonville, is you have to go over the freaking Buckman. So please note, if that is you and you're okay with it, then also note if there's any type of distraction on the Buckman, any type of stalled vehicle, any type of accident, you will be late at least 1 hour, at least 1 hour. Now this is a 4-lane bridge and it also, it goes up, it goes down, it crosses the St. John's River. It is 3 miles of bridge. That is the only way you're really getting connected into Jacksonville. It also dumps into Mandarin. So these are our bridges. I hope you liked getting to know the 7 bridges of Jacksonville.